Hi, thanks for joining me. We're here on the ground at Ruby Valley, Montana, which is right next to Twin Bridges, Montana. About to start off on a cross-country flight to West Yellowstone, Montana. After takeoff, we'll climb and try to get up into, get some lift up there in the Tobacco Root Mountains. And go from there, see what kind of lift we have today. Today we have it's a warm day in July, and we have some winds out of the southwest, about 10 to 12 knots. And we've also got some possibility of some thermal lift as well. I'm not a sailplane pilot or a glider pilot. I'm learning so much with this Discus-2 in the flight simulator, and it is so much fun and challenging. Not sure how much this correlates to reality, but sure is a lot of fun. pretty significant sink. I'm gonna have to double back and keep climbing because I'm not gonna make it across that valley to the Madison Range without first getting to the top of this range here in the Tobacco Fruit Mountains. Looks like it might be kind of rough and take a little time to get to the summit of this, or to get to the top of this range. Hopefully we can get up there quick. Again, I'm not a sailplane or glider pilot, so I know that, and this is Microsoft Flight Simulator, so I know I'm certain I'm doing things wrong and probably pretty dangerous, things you wouldn't do in reality. So fun. I've been able to virtually explore so many places and so many beautiful mountain areas doing this. Some places I've been personally, but most of these places that I soar in Microsoft Flight Simulator and do YouTube videos on, most of these are places I've really never been in person. So. Starting to smooth out a little bit. Might have spoken too soon though. I've never seen the Tobacco Root Mountains in person, or the Madison Range over there. Although I have been over to Gardner, Montana, which is, I guess, on the eastern side of that Madison Range, which is the north entrance to Yellowstone National Park. And I've also been over to West Yellowstone, west entrance to the park. Much smoother now, and a lot stronger lift, more consistent lift. Still got a ways to go to get up there to the top of the range. Out to the west, see the beacon light of the Ruby Valley Airport just took off of. Generally, the route that I wanted to go is about almost right at 100 miles. Of course, that didn't count all this back and forth. Southwest over there. I was expecting some sort of a sink right there, but just not. I'm ready for it though. Thank you. forgot to check the altimeter there before that big sink, so I'm not sure exactly how much altitude we lost there, but we'll get it back. Looks like we may be nearing the some of the tops here, some of the scary. Start moving south along this ridge. Watching speed and I'd like to be a little higher. trying to stay on these southwest or west facing slopes. Coming up on 1,000. See the valley out there to the left, the valley, and then across that valley is the Madison Range. Where we're headed. Sure is beautiful. Try to jump over to from this ridge over to this ridge over here, hopefully without taking up too much of a sink. About 300 or 400 feet there, it looks like. If I were a passenger, I don't think I'd be able to handle this turbulence very well. But as a pilot, that would be fun. I'm thinking, I don't know if this is right or not, but I'm thinking that I don't want to just head straight out east, which is off the wing there, because I'm quite certain there'll be a pretty significant sink on the other side of that mountain, those two peaks there. So what I'm going to try to do, whether it's right or not, I don't know. I'll try to go off the the south end here, gently off the, as it slopes to the south, which is straight ahead. And then once clear of these mountains, then turn to the east. Simba. Oh, I should have saw that. Got on the wrong side of the slope there. It was under the nose, didn't see it, but I should have recognized that. Heading to the left out there, the big lake is, according to the chart, is Ennis Lake or Ennis Lake. I'm not sure how you say that. And my plan is to kind of head to the south shore of that lake and then pick up that ridge over there. Alright, so we're starting out across the valley at, let's say 10,800. sure if that's thermal lift or we're just getting lift off of these spines and hills. There's about a 2,000 foot loss when we first left that ridge back there. Well, assuming we have those same southwest winds when we get over here, we should be okay. Waves on the water, we have some wind anyway. Should be in range now of an airport out there to the south, down in the valley there. Ennis, Big Sky Airport. Out there in the valley, you see some roads running straight. Those roads are running directly south to the horizon there, and then I believe the airport is there. range anyway. Those are some beautiful mountains. Back up through 9,000 now. my thought and plan is here on this Madison Range is that I don't think I need to get all the way to the top of that range and go south. So my plan is to kind of stay sort of here towards the west edge and just follow it on south as long as I think it'll be some decent lift and probably a lot smoother. Although it would be cool to get up there and have a look at the scenery up there. And there is the Ennis, Big Sky Airport. Also planning just if I can get up to 10 to 11,000, go ahead and see if I can pick up the speed and maintain that altitude along the front side here. At least to 10,000 though. Oh, that's so beautiful. Paying attention to the GPS there. Didn't have it centered on our aircraft. Wasn't even paying attention. Let's see if we can get up to at least 10,000. Hopefully up towards 11,000. up some speed. Simulated beauty. Through 10,000. Quite a ways out in that direction there is Gardner, Montana, which I'm recording this in July of 2022, and so it was recently in the news with a lot of significant flooding both in Gardner and in Yellowstone National Park. Early in the summer, with lots and lots of rain. Increase in speed, I guess we get the increase in bumps. Oh, that ridge over there looks very tempting. Yeah, come back another day and do that one. Something that could cause us to sink if the wind is out of the southwest still. Join this ridge over here. Get a little last little push and get some altitude. To get over to West Yellowstone. Thank you. that worked out well so far. Now I'm just trying to stay on the windward slopes on the southwest side here. Southwest facing slopes. Looks like a nice ridge line for the winds we seem to have. Let's jump right over here and follow that. One, two, dabs. Amazing. And so beautiful. Oh, man. I'm glad you came up to the top of these peaks here. They're so beautiful. Simulated beauty. Lucky and go to the right there on this without losing too much, hopefully. Wow, coming up on 13,000. Still climbing. Awesome view. right, well, according to the chart, that road that's up there ahead and to the left that's running straight south there, kind of takes a curve and then bends around the mountain. That's Reynolds Pass. That's where we're headed to go around the south end of that mountain, and then turn to the east and start descending towards West Yellowstone. Kind of a longer cross-country flight for a YouTube video, I guess. I don't know if people have the patience to watch. Certainly not the whole thing, but even maybe bits and pieces through to the end anyway. If you're still here, I appreciate it. Had a couple of rough spots there towards the beginning of our trip here, but it's all working out really nicely. Actually, I didn't think I'd have this this much altitude at this point. That's pretty fortunate. Beautiful valley, lots of rangeland. I'm sure quite a bit of cattle out there. Can't imagine the amount of wildlife in this sparsely populated area of the country. We are just west of Yellowstone National Park. Lots of wilderness here. You can see this pointer the there's a lake here, and then all this little finger that points out to the southeast there, right there at the end of that, out there is the West Yellowstone Airport that we are attempting to make it to, which looks pretty promising at this point. So it won't be long. I have not been to the West Yellowstone Airport either in real life or in flight simulator, so this will be a first. About an hour, almost an hour and 15 minutes flight so far. You know, I know longer YouTube videos, longer run YouTube videos aren't as popular, and if you're still here, I really appreciate it. I know it's a lot more fun to fly in flight simulator than to watch videos of it. You're still watching, I really appreciate it, and I hope you enjoy this simulated scenery. It's beautiful. Let me look on a chart real quick, see what that, I forgot the name of that lake. Hebgen Lake, H-E-B-G-E-N Lake. Like a very out of the way, peaceful place to go fishing. Looks like some roadways and maybe some campgrounds there along the south edge there. Can't tell, but kind of looks like it. All right, well, I haven't been here before, so I'm looking for the airport out there, sort of on the very far end of this finger on the lake here. too eager to start descending until I can get it in sight. GPS, and I believe I have a airport in sight there. Assuming the winds are out of the southwest, it'll go over the top and then make a left downwind. .6650 is the field elevation there. Get some spoilers and make an approach. Well, that's a beautiful lake. Looks like, I don't know if those are houses or neighborhoods, or if that's camping. That would be awesome, actually, to be able to camp there and then go in and out of Yellowstone Park. It's so hard to find, really hard to get reservations and find camping inside the park. Well, it looks like it'd be a little bit high on pattern altitude, but get down okay. certainly looks like Yellowstone so far. Wheel down. Not a great landing. If you stuck around all the way to the end here, I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed it. And here we are, West Yellowstone. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.